In this episode and the next, we're going to learn how to create two connected nodes by left dragging on the graph space, how to add a connection to a vertex by left dragging on it, and how to delete vertices using the right click. So the drag events fall into two categories, those triggered by clicking on the graph area and those triggered while clicking on the vertices. Okay, so last week we created the ability to add a vertex. However, we can do that with any mouse button. What I want to do is restrict it to the left clicks only. To do that is pretty simple. There we go, so if I click with the left button, it puts a node down. Any other button, nothing happens. Next, when I left click and drag, I want to create two vertices. First, let me organize this code a little bit. So we'll add the drag events to the graph. Okay, so when the drag is detected, it will create a new node. And we'll need to update its position in this method here. So we'll create a global variable. And we'll change it so the createVertex method returns a vertex. And we better make sure this is a left click event. And to make the code a little simpler, I'm going to change create vertex to create and add vertex. There we go, but okay, the problem here is that vertex temp continues to point to the node after the drag and drop is complete. So I will add another event. And we can just set vertex temp to null. So click and drag. There we go. Okay, so the graph events are done. Now we need to work on the vertices events. So we can't do the first event until we have more of the GUI built. So let's move on to the second one, where we can click on an existing vertex and drag it to create a new vertex which is connected to it. So when a vertex detects a new drag event, we want to check if it was a left mouse event. Then create a new node. Let's just test that quickly. So I'll put a node down and I'll drag it. Okay, so two problems here. First of all, when I left drag on a vertex, it shouldn't move like this. So let's fix that first. There, that's better. Next, because the mouse event has been generated by the vertex, the x and y coordinates are relative to the vertices origin, which is about here. That's why the nodes are being created in this top left corner. So what I'll have to do is, instead of passing a mouse event to the create and add vertex method, I'll just pass the coordinates. And I'll want to set this new vertex relative to the vertex it was dragged from, like this method. So I put a vertex down and then I drag from it. And now I just need to update its location in the dragged method. go. And again, I forgot to set vertex temp to null after the operation was complete. So put down a node and drag from it. There we go. Okay, so we handled two events there. Now we just want to focus on removing a vertex when we right-click on it. Now, a problem that I have is that I want to delete the node when the mouse button is released, but only if it was the right-click and if there wasn't a drag event. The problem is, once the mouse button's released, I have no way of finding out which button was pressed. So what I'll have to do is add a vertex pressed event. Create a global variable. Add the vertex to it. This is marked for deletion. Then if a drag event occurs, we can just set that variable to null. If a drag event doesn't occur, then by the time this method is called, it won't be null and we can delete it. And then set it to null. Let's test that. So I create a node, I right click and hold it, and I can drag it around. But if I right click it once, it's deleted.